All right, everybody. Good to see everybody here this morning. I'm going to ask you all to stand, if you would, please, and turn to page number 361 in your red book. 361 in your red. We're going to sing the first, second, and last of "The Son Hath Made Me Free" on 361. Let's all sing out. 361.
You'll have to start giving me the notice a little bit ahead of time there, Matthew. Takes me a while to get. Oh, I have money. I've got checks here. Money. This is from the online church. We've put it right in there. You know what to do with it?
Amen.
I bet you do. Here's the message for today. Paying it forward. How do you prepay God for His goodness to us? Paying it forward. If you haven't got one when you came in, get it when you go out. Amen. And yours are right over there, Ronnie. Don't forget it. Okay, Ronnie's distributing these things, and we praise the Lord for that. Amen. Everything's been wiped down, scrubbed down twice, sometimes three times, sprayed. We're trying to make sure that everybody's clean. And I even had an experience this morning, just to let you know how sanitized I am. Last night, I was drinking my coffee, and I put the cup in the sink, as I always do, and ran it full of water. You know, as I always do, I'm a creature of habit. Only thing, I put a little soap in it, just to be on the safe side, as I never do. And so when I got up this morning and made my coffee, I just emptied it out and stuck it in there. And so I've tastes a little funny, but you know what? It's not bad. Soap and coffee's not really bad. And so I can tell you, I'm clean all the way down. Amen. All right. Thank you for your presence here. That is a hard decision that we had to make on Wednesday night. Sorry about that, but we are here. And Lord willing, we'll be here tonight. And Lord willing, we'll be here Wednesday night. We want to be a church where people can know that we are. I know that we're a target. I realize that. I am a target because I'm old. And I have respiratory problems, and I realize I am a target, but I want to go down fighting. I want to go down preaching the gospel. So whatever happens, that's up to God. Nursery, check the board. No ladies meeting, no men's meeting coming up whenever it was supposed to come up. On the 23rd, it's been canceled over till April in whatever's next month. What is the next month? April coming up. So that's coming up then, all right? So no ladies meeting coming up this particular month right here. Look at your bulletin and everything. Now on the back page, you see that vote thing today and tonight. If you want to go ahead and vote today, if you're not going to be here tonight, or if you are, you have a ballot in your bulletin there. Go ahead and mark it yes or no on all four of those different lines right there. And you can read it right here. I won't read it for the sake of time, but there they are: to establish the maintenance thing, to put Zan in there, to establish the associate pastor, and put Jordan in there. Four different things. Mark it either today or tonight. Please, please, please don't vote. Well, go ahead and vote twice if you want to, but that's all right. As they say, vote often and early. So mark your ballots today with a yes or no on 1, 2, 3, or 4, and a deacon will pick it up in the offering time or whatever else, okay? And so go ahead and take care of that. If you're coming back tonight and want to wait till tonight, that's fine. You can do that. It will not be counted until tonight. And then we'll pull the trigger on a lot of different things, okay? Thank you so very much for being here outside of our church. What is that number again? I forget that number. What is our number, Ronnie? You know? 423-623-9056. 9056. Okay, call Nick. He's waiting on your phone call over there from outside of our church. I realize a lot of folks might be listening in today on WLIK, watching the video stream, watching the YouTube and all of that. But the number to call, 423-623-9056. Call right now. Prayer time comes up in about 15 minutes or so. What's coming up right now is the choir is going to sing for you. Let's have a word of prayer together. Father, thank you for your blessings today. Thank you for the opportunity of ministry right here. Lord, this is a tough time. You got it. You got it. We got it, and we're with you. And so I thank you for that. Now bless the choir. Bless the children's church. Bless the preacher as we preach. And help us, Lord, in all that we do this day. Everything that happens today is in your hands. And we thank you for that. The pure hands, the sanitized hands of our Father. Thank you, Lord, for that. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
y'all stay seated as the choir stands once again on 333, Jesus is All the World to Me. We'll sing the first and the last of 333. Song, I'm going to ask you to stand and turn to page number 342, When Our Lord Shall Come Again. We'll sing that first verse all together, and then the choir will come down. 342.
For your presence here for today. God bless you for being here in our presence. I realize a lot of churches are not able to have services today, and we're coming to you live from the West End Baptist Church. You are a very important part of our service, and I thank you so very much for the privilege that we have. You pray for us, we'll be praying for you. We'll be going to prayer time in about 5 minutes, so you can still call. The number to call is 623-9056 here in Newport, 423-623-9056. You can call right now, talk to Nick. He will take your prayer requests. He'll bring them out, and we'll have special prayer just for you. Go ahead and make that call right now, 423-623-9056. Thank you so very much for your prayers. You pray for us, we'll pray for you. Come see us anytime. God bless you. What are we going to do today? We must be going to do something. You going to do something? All right. Oh, she's going to tell us. All right. All right, everybody. This is a kind of a new thing here that we've got started. The children's church is going to tell you what they're going to have in their service for today, okay? It's what Diane or somebody's going to be preaching on. Is it you? Okay. All right. This is part of our children's church. Charlotte?
Luke 10:27. So he answered and said, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength, and with all your mind, and your neighbor as yourself. Our lesson today in Children's Church is, who is your neighbor?
All right, good job, good job. Thank you, Charlotte. Thank you, honey. Good job. All right, ushers, would you all come? Dwayne, would you come with the prayer time, please?
Good morning. This morning on the prayer list, we have missionaries, revival in Israel, all our caregivers and medical personnel, utility and emergency workers, our national and world leaders, our pastor, and our city, county, and state law enforcement. On our permit request this morning, we have Terry Allen, Juanita Burgess, Betty Grooms, Jerry Hall, Robert and Pat Hare, Ronnie Hartzell, Harold Hudson, Ralph Husky, Betty and Austin Ray Kiker, Tony Lehman, Earl and Betty Mathis, Wiley Morgan, Edna Ottinger, Wayne Parker, Chop and Johnny Phillips, Joanne Parter, Adela Prince, Betty Sperry, Steve Strong, Martha Thomas, and Billy Violet. On a military request this morning, we have Mark Waters, Stan Helpner, Daniel Salisbury, and Robert Lee. On a brief families this morning, we have the families of Tiffany Cogdale, Laura McCoy Holmes, Tommy Stoker, and Roy Greer. On a prayer list this morning, we have Steve Blanchett, Stephanie Brady, Lexi Ellison, Michael Goodrich, Roger and Sharon Gray, missionaries, Bryson Presnell, Emma Rose Stiles, Conway Wilson, Laney Bryant, Euretha Carson, Jeff and Joe McMahon, Rita and Jim McNabb, Vicki Ogle, Joy Strange, Dale and Ginger Brown, Lindsay Bryant, Bobby Crum, Martha Gray, Louise Husky, Steve and Charlene Johnson, Charlie Jones, Betty McAndrew, Allison and Dylan Battaglia, Frank Bible, Walker Boudreau, Mike Collins, Joanne Eastman, a family in Boone, North Carolina, Patty Furtick, Cecil and Renee Hewitt, Don and Aubrey Jones, Sam Kiker, Brian Landrum, Frank, Buddy, and Trent Large. This morning, we've added the names of a lady named Lucille, Patty Lerner, Tommy Lehman, Laura McCory, and D.K. Burchett. Also, we've added the names of Andy Holt and Don and Audrey Jones. Is there anyone else we'd like to add this morning? All right, today is the National Day of Prayer. And Pastor Tom set aside a time to pray. So if you'd like to, join me at the altar at this time, and we'll go to the Lord in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we come to you this morning as a nation, asking you to have mercy upon us, Lord. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for the opportunity to come to you, the petitions on this prayer request, Lord, and also the burdens on people's heart, Lord. I just pray that you strengthen the Christians of this nation, Lord, through this time of disease, Lord. I just pray that we shine forth as beacons of light, Lord. Let the world know who holds tomorrow, Lord, and that you are in control no matter what may come, Lord. Lord, we pray for our national and world leaders, Lord. We know that the decisions they make are hard ones, Lord. We just pray that they seek your counsel, Lord, before every decision is made, Lord. And we just pray that they follow your will, Lord. Lord, be with this church, Lord. Let it stand strong in this community, Lord. And let people know that there's always a place to come where they can hear your word, Lord, where they can come and be welcome, Lord, and hear the word of God. Faith come by hearing and hearing by the word of God, Lord. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, I just pray a special blessing on those that are able to make it here this morning, Lord. And I pray a blessing on those that are watching on the internet, Lord, or listening by the radio, Lord. I just pray that your hand of protection be put around them. Keep their families safe and healthy, Lord, and keep these families safe and healthy. Dear Heavenly Father, we also remember those that bereaved this morning, Lord. We just pray that you comfort them, Lord. And if they knew the Lord Jesus Christ as their Savior, Lord, we just pray that you comfort them with the knowledge that they will meet again one day, and they are in the loving arms of Jesus this very morning, Lord. Lord, we come to you this morning giving you all praise, honor, and glory for everything that will occur here, Lord. And we ask all these things in Jesus Christ's name. Amen.
National Day of Prayer for our nation. and for the world in the wake of COVID-19. I don't know what's going to happen with it. I really don't. I don't know what decisions we're going to have to make here. But I do know who's in charge. And it's not me. And it's not you. It's the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Special treat for you today. David and Donnie. David, you're going to sing and Donnie's going to do the recitation. Oh, I've got that backwards. Go right on and take your place over there. Cheryl will be playing for them. It's one thing when you pray, if you know all the mechanics of how to pray. We pray in Jesus' name. We do all those things. But you have to pray in faith. You pray in faith. Listen to this beautiful song.
How many times have you prayed for something big or small? How long did you have to wait? Or did the answer come at all? Words are mere expressions of thought and nothing more. Believing is what really counts, and faith is what unlocks the door.
Wonderful ministry there, huh? Faith unlocks the door. Oh my. I stand before you today as a guy that I've never had to pastor a church, never got to pastor a church that has been through something like this. We've been through the flu together. We've been through weather, snow, and all that stuff together down at Warburg. We went through tornadoes together. And it's one of those things that you just never know what to do. It's a tough decision, If you make it, you're wrong, half the people. if you make it wrong, you're half the people are mad. If you don't make it right, the other half are mad. So you just never know. So it just goes with the territory. When I accepted this ministry, I felt like that God had a place to serve. And one of the reasons that He, I think, sent me up here and brought me back up here was because of the outreach, the ministry, the radio, the video, and all the things. I had no idea. I had no clue that this was going to be one of those things. Here's a kid from Frog Pond, Tennessee. And the things that we say here can ricochet around the world in a nanosecond. I want you to think about that. We ran a test to see how long it takes this message to get to the island of Fiji. Anybody know where Fiji is? It takes 2 seconds for it to get there. Think about that. I say it now. I say it now. I say it now. It echoes around the world. It has that potential. Radio is a tremendous ministry. The internet is a tremendous ministry. And part of what I learned while I was at Wartburg was due to being on the radio down there at WECO. A friend of mine, Ross Woody, pastor friend of mine, I ordained him in this church right here to be a pastor, and he was sent down to a church in Lenore City, and he called me one day and said, "You want to get a radio station on the air?" And I said, "Well, yeah, be the highlight of my day." So I was at Wartburg at the time. He called. We went to a little station, WBBX, in Kingston, Tennessee, 100 watts of romping, stomping power. And we went down there, and we got it on the air, played gospel music, and I learned how to operate the board. I got my license. I'm a licensed board operator. That don't mean a thing to you, but it did to me. And so when the blizzard of 93 hit, I can tell you all about that, but I got a friend here who can tell you more about that than I can. Brother Ed Knight is here. Ed, would you come up here, please? I want you to share with us just a little bit for today. This is the station owner now. He was the station sales manager. It's the one I keep telling you about, the one that didn't have good sense. That's him. You'll understand why in just a few moments. Ed Knight is here. His wife Susan is here. His son Andrew is here. And his wife Kristen is here. Wave at me. Wave at me. So they'll think you're not mad at me. Amen. Thank you so very much. I want him just to come and share with us. Now, Ed, you got 5 minutes. In radio, you know how 5 minutes goes, okay? Come on, brother.
Yes, sir. Good morning, everybody. My name is Ed Knight, and I'm here with my family this morning. And we were actually on our way to Charlotte to do a broadcast at the NASCAR Hall of Fame, our radio station celebrating our 50th anniversary. But we got up yesterday morning, found out the Hall of Fame was closed until the first of the month, so we decided to come up to Newport and say hello to Tom. We've been threatening to do this for several years, so we're here. So my name is Ed Knight, as I said, and my family own and operate WECO Radio in Wartburg. We've got 3 stations in our broadcast group: WECO AM 940, which is our original station. Our new FM translator is 95.5. They both broadcast a Christian gospel format. Our most powerful station that's soon to go to 10,500 watts is WECO FM 101.3, and it has a country music format. We also broadcast local high school sports that Tom used to help out on, and he would bring suitcase after suitcase after suitcase after unnecessary suitcase of equipment to the press box. We also, down the road here at Tennessee, Big Orange Country, we do the Vol football, basketball, Lady Vol basketball, and we've done NASCAR for 50 years. If you're over in the Morgan County area, which is west of Oak Ridge, about 40 minutes, be glad to have you listen in. You can also listen worldwide. We indeed have the same technology that you guys here have. Our broadcasters spread worldwide on our phone app and also WECORadio.com. And just a moment to say, we started in 1970, and this is our anniversary year. We're celebrating 50 years of being on the air. As I said earlier, it's good to be with you this morning. And I'd like to share a few thoughts with you about this guy right here that you maybe think you know. Mr. Mooty's Preacher Mooty in Wartburg, he's known as Preacher Tom. I Googled friend the other day, and yes, Tom, I do know how to get on the internet. Yeah, I Googled, and I asked Google what the definition of friend was. And friend is someone you know and like spending time with. And that exactly defines the relationship I have with this man right here to my right. I've known him for over 25 years. I first met him when he pastored Wartburg First Baptist Church, which has broadcast their Sunday morning worship services, just like you all who do here, and that's been on the air for almost 50 years. To what he referenced about the blizzard of 93, the church is just across the street, literally, from our radio station, so everything was gridlocked that winter day in 1993, February, March, as I recall. The snow was up this high. And Tom was gracious enough to come across from the Parsons over to the radio station, help our Sunday morning guy with all the massive church announcements. I mean, he couldn't go anywhere. So as 11 o'clock approached, it became apparent that Wartburg First Baptist Church was not going to be able to conduct services. You couldn't move, couldn't get out. So Tom said, I got this. So he moved the DJ out. He got behind the microphone. He started preaching. He started praying. He started reading scripture. And he got some CDs and started playing some good Southern gospel music. My eyes kept getting bigger and bigger. And needless to say, I was impressed with Preacher Tom. So when it comes to live talk on the radio, you either have it or you don't have it. Preacher Tom has it. I discovered what you already know, Preacher Tom has a gift of gab. So after the blizzard was over, we got together and talked, kicked around a few ideas, and we decided to come together, and Tom agreed to host a radio show called Gospel Time that started in 1993 and is still on our air today at WECO. I'd like to share a personal story with you. About 20 years ago, I had a ruptured disc in my neck. It was causing me severe pain. I couldn't sleep. My daily routine was turned upside down. It was hard to concentrate at work. My neurosurgeon wanted to do surgery. Now, this is not your ordinary type surgery, if there is such a thing as ordinary surgery. This involved going through the front of my neck, slicing my neck open, moving my esophagus, and moving my jugular vein. What could possibly go wrong with that? Well, this surgery had also had some severe complications, possibly. Our two sons were still at home. I had a radio station to worry about. And to be honest, the whole idea of cutting my neck open had me quite scared. Time went by, continued to hurt. More time went by, continued to hurt. And I was having a pretty bad way at the time. So one day, Tom was walking down the hallway, and I was in my office, and I said, Tom, come in here, please. And we sat down, and I said to him, I really would like to have this surgery and get rid of this pain in my neck. But the idea of getting up out of that hospital bed, getting on that gurney, going down that long hallway to the operating room just literally scares me to death. Mooty didn't miss a beat. He looked me square in the eye and he said, do you believe? Well, yes, I said. Then Tom said, you won't be alone. That's exactly what I needed to hear. I scheduled the surgery, it was successful, and I stand here before you today, reasonably healthy for 66 years of age, but I thank Tom for giving me the courage to move forward with my surgery. Jude chapter 1, verse 22 says, and of some have compassion, making a difference. Tom Moody's made a difference at our radio station, he's made a difference in my life, and I know he's making a difference for all you good folks here in Newport at West End Baptist Church. At this time, this is a surprise. At this time, I would like to ask my son Andrew to come forward, my daughter-in-law Kristen, please. And we have a little token of appreciation. Tom is celebrating 20 years of being on WECO with Gospel Time. And Tom, on behalf of everyone at WECO and the Knight family, we'd like to present you with a plaque of appreciation for hosting Gospel Time on WECO for 20 years.
Gospel Time. Thank you, guys. Full of surprises, aren't you, Ed? You ought not to do that to the preacher. I love that family. I want you to know that it's been a wonderful ministry, still going on. Thank you so very much for your understanding down through the years. Let me get settled down just a little bit because I got to talk to the church before I bring the message this morning. I am 79 years of age. I have respiratory problems. So I realize that in some countries, if they had socialized medicine, I would be allowed to die. Quite frankly, I would be one of the ones probably trying to get in. I don't know why we spend so much time and money to stay alive when it's the best thing ever happened to a child of God is to be able to die. But we do. We want to stay alive. Death is an enemy. And I'd be one of the first ones to go. And I realize that I'll probably be one of the first ones if this COVID-19 takes over here. I do not know what is going to happen. But I do know this. I know that I have not been released from the mandate that God gave to me over half a century ago. And He called me to do it, and I have tried to train and get so I could do it. But I am taking precautions. It would be stupid of me to fill a bathtub full of COVID-19 virus and then take a bath in it. It'd be stupid of me to drink it and say, "Now, Lord, protect me." That's not faith. That's foolishness. We need to take precautions. Everything in this church has been wiped down twice, and it will be wiped down again. 87 of the 88 keys on the piano were wiped down. Larry, you and Cheryl had to figure out which one did not get wiped down. It's probably one of those things that you all don't use, like middle C or something like that. Every doorknob, every kick plate, every door inside and outside, all the wood on the pews, everything is done. This choir, this pulpit, especially this pulpit, has been wiped down, every microphone, all of that stuff, just for taking precautions, because I don't know. Listen, I have all the faith in the world, but I still am not a foolish person. We want to take all the precautions. It's easy to criticize, very easy to criticize. I read what people said. Any church that canceled the service, that's not a church, and that guy's not a preacher. I got that. I understand that. It's easy to say that. It's a very tough decision to make. But I want to know, I want you to know, that although I am a target for this COVID-19 virus, old and respiratory problems, but I want to present the gospel with every last ounce of breath I've got. If it happens, it happens. It is not going to happen until God says it's okay. It's not going to happen. I don't care if we're going to be the last church standing. We're going to keep standing and keep presenting the gospel. I do not want anybody getting sick because of coming here. But I don't want somebody going to hell because we're not here for them to come to. I don't want that. I don't want that. We're not here to please anybody. We're not here to prove anything. I'm not here to say how strong we are and all that kind of stuff. Probability is that you probably have already been exposed to that COVID-19. Probability is that I have already been exposed to it. And probability is that those that have it probably will not feel any effects from it, but some of us might. Some of us very well could. We are an aging congregation. I know that. And some of those things that happen, well, we have underlying medical conditions. Yes, we are. The problem is we are more susceptible than the children and most of the young people today. We're going to take precautions. We are taking precautions outside the doors of our church right now, and we're going to take precautions inside the doors as well. This is not a lapse of faith. I got all the faith in the world. But God says, what is in your hand? What is in your hand? What have I given you to do? What have I given you the tools to work with? So if you can't or just would rather not come to be with us in these services, just remember we're coming out to you. You have a ballot in your bulletin there. If you're not going to be able to come back tonight, I would appreciate you voting one way or the other on all four of those motions. Fold it, and we'll pick them up after it's over. If you do not choose to do so, leave it open, leave it on the pew. We'll pick it up and probably use it tonight or whatever. Simple truth is, if I felt like that God was through with me to do what He was leading me to do when I came here, then I'd been gone a long time ago. I'd been gone to heaven a long time ago. But God's keeping me here, and so praise the Lord. I'm not through. I'm not through. Our audio is as clear as a bell. We're working on the TV. And before long, I wish, I wish I had pulled the trigger on the high-def cameras when I felt like God told me to. I felt like God told me to do that about 4 or 5 weeks ago, but I was trying to be a good steward of God's funds and all this kind of stuff, and so I was waiting until the money comes in. The money has come in. We need to pull the trigger on it, and so we'll be voting on that Wednesday night, Lord willing. I ask you to pray for me because I fit the description of the number one target of COVID-19. I'm old, I'm 79, and I have underlying respiratory problems. But that is in God's hands. It is in God's hands. And I say that very totally, in God's hands. We are used to doing things mediocrity. Good enough for God. No, it's not. God lives on Main Street. I do not believe in giving bent cans to God. Bring in the best you got. That's what God deserves. And so I just want you to understand, I need your prayers. I don't want to be the reason why people get sick. I say again, but I do not want to be the reason people are not saved, because we weren't here for them. I will be here until God gets through with me. Give me a camera and a radio mic and a telephone line. We'll put it out on the air. We'll do it. We'll do it. But I do ask you to pray for me. Would you do that? Thank you so very much. Now then, let's preach. Let's bring the message. Amen. Pay it forward. Pay it forward. Pay it forward. The title comes from an old expression. You thought it was new, didn't you? Pay it forward. Hadn't heard that before. Well, how many were here? I don't know. How many were here? Let's just say to see one of the ancient Greek comedies. Anybody? How many were here in 1841? Anybody? Nobody? That's when it first started. It was featured in a stage play in 1916. It included in a sci-fi book in 1951, Pay It Forward. It generally means to plan ahead. To plan ahead. Well, that's what we're trying to do. Plan ahead. We got out yesterday and wiped down all the wood surfaces and the carpet surfaces and things like that, the doorknob, the metal surfaces, especially that, to plan ahead, to be prepared, to plan ahead. We also got plenty of toilet paper. In the bathrooms. Have you ever heard of anything? I don't know what is wrong with people. I don't know what's wrong with people. It so happened that I needed some toilet paper. I usually buy it in 47 packs, 47 rolls to the pack. I like to stay prepared. I just go once a year to the store. And so happened I had to go. And I was afraid the press is going to be taking a picture of me, old faithless preacher coming out with toilet paper. I had to have it, I was down to a couple of rolls or whatever. Listen, pay it forward. Pay it forward. It's the opposite of pay it back. It refers to doing a good thing for somebody because somebody has done something nice to you. He says in 1 John, this is the witness of God which he testified concerning his son. He that believes. I don't remember the illustration that Ed gave. I don't remember that. I don't doubt that it happened because I had quite a ministry. The station manager came in to see me one time while I was on the air. And during the time that we were playing songs, and she said, I want to talk to you about my soul. She says, I want to know. I want to know that my sins have been forgiven. We never know who you're reaching. You never know. We don't know. Little kids that come up to me saying, you don't remember me. Saturday was a week ago. A guy drove in here in a pickup truck that's about the size of a bulldozer and says, you don't remember me. I said, no, I really don't. I really don't. He had a letter that I wrote to him 40 some odd years ago, framed on his wall. And I said, what? A letter? And then I remembered I wrote him a letter to congratulate him on doing something. I don't know what it was, but we never know. If you believe on the Son of God, you have borne that witness within yourself. And if you don't believe, then God, in the Son of God, you have called God a liar. You've called him a liar. And what I want to talk to you about is knowing what God has done for us and then pay it forward. Pay it forward. This is the record. This is the testimony that God gave to us, eternal life. And this life is in his Son. 1 John 5:11. It's 1 John 5:11. His life is in his Son. He who has the Son, verse 12, has that life. Present tense. You have that life. If you do not have the Son of God, you do not have that spiritual life. And I wrote you these things. I told you I wrote you these things, he said. Those of you who believe in the name of the Son of God, so that in order that you may most assuredly know that you have. This is what we have right now. You, I, we are living in eternity. Did you know that? You're living in eternity now. You're going to live eternally somewhere right now. And you're living in eternity now. This is the confidence. Here's the theme verse. This is the confidence, verse 14, which we have before him, that if we pray in faith, if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. According to his will. Prayer is the key to heaven, but faith unlocks the door. I wish I had written that. I wish I had written that. And since we know, verse 15, that he hears us in whatsoever we ask, in his will, in his name, we know that we will have the requests which we have asked from him. The key phrase of that is in his will. It clearly tells us when we pray in his will, according to what he wants for us, in agreements with his will and for our life and work, we have the assurance that it shall be done. That's not self-assurance. That's Christ assurance. I'm not self-assured. I'm Christ assured. You are Christ assured. And there's a big, big difference. Big difference in that. You share the same confidence expressed by Paul when he says, I can do what? All things in the power of the one who empowers me. That's faith in his word. Faith in his word. It's not feelings. Feelings change. Feelings change with the wind that blows. But faith is the spring from which all confidence comes. God's word is changeless. It is flawless. It is therefore most reliable. And your Christian life is based on that. Or as the old man says, you ain't got no Christian life. I like the line in Forrest Gump, you ain't got no legs, Lieutenant Dan. If you don't have faith in Christ, you ain't got no salvation, Lieutenant Dan. It's the same thing. It's the very same thing. You can see very clear the confidence that you can and should derive from the Christian life. Past, present, and future. Three things in the message for today. Number one, salvation does have a past life. Sins can be forgiven. Sins can be washed away. Your soul can be saved. And if your soul is saved, those sins disappear. That's what salvation is. If that has happened in your life, that is your past. What did you do? The Bible says, if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart. Two things. Confess with your mouth, believe with your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. There it is. Now, you can believe that or not. You don't have to believe me. I'm just giving you what the Bible says. Everything is in that sermon booklet. You get that booklet, everything is listed right there. For with the heart, a person believes. That results in our righteousness. With the mouth, confession is made, and that results in salvation. You done that? If you have, no reason to doubt. Now, don't be foolish, but there's no reason to doubt or lose confidence. How can you doubt somebody as big as God? How can you do that? How can you have anything but the greatest confidence as you read the promises that God has for us? Number two, the church is living proof that God has a presence. Oh, listen, folks, I'm happy being saved. You? I am. You? I'm having a time of my life. I'm doing what I like to do. I talked to a lady from Morgan County the other day. She said, "Brother Tom, how you feeling?" I said, "Well, I'm doing all right." She says, "You're doing what you like to do." I said, "I'm doing what I'm having the biggest time of my life doing." "Well, then you're doing all right. You're doing fine." Listen, living salvation has a present life. I read about a Christian that said, "I know my sins have been forgiven. I got that. I'm sure I'm going to heaven. I got that. My hang-up is not about my past because my sins have been forgiven. My hang-up is not about the future because my future is assured. My problem is today. Does the Bible speak to me today?" They would say today, is COVID-19 in the Bible somewhere, plagues and all that kind of stuff? Tell me, does salvation relate to my life today? How do I stand before God today? Today. Well, I got some Bible. The Bible says there is, therefore, now, what? No condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus. Quit putting yourself down. Because when you put yourself down, you're putting Christ down that saved you and brought you into His family. You are looking at a child of the living God. And to quote a line from Ghostbusters, there are many perks in being a child of a God. There are many perks in knowing that your sins have been forgiven. The Holy Spirit agrees with our spirit that we are the children of God. And if you are His children, you are His heirs. What does that mean, an heir? Somebody talk to me. An heir means what? You get it all. You might have to share it with a big ugly brother down in Florida. But you get it all. You are an heir of God. What does that mean to you? It also says that we're joint heirs with Jesus the Christ. Now think about that. He lets us share equally. Equally? The one that died for me shares with me equally? That's how you stand in front of God right now. Three reasons why you can face temptation every day. First of all, no temptation will come your way that has not already been faced by somebody just like you. Last generation went through it. Generation before that went through it. Generation before that went through it. You'll get through it too. They faced all kinds of things going on. You'll get through it too. Secondly, when God stays with you, He will not allow a temptation to come your way that you cannot resist. He won't do it. He will not put more on you than you can bear. And with every temptation, number three, God promises to provide a means of escape. Got a visit from the fire marshal when we were building this church. He says, "What is the seating capacity of the auditorium?" I said, 750. He said, 750. Looked at his little chart and he says, "You need five exits out of this building. For 750 people, you need five exits. 1, 2, 3, 4. And he says, "What about that door right there?" I said, "Well, it doesn't lead to the outside." He said, "Well, it will when I get through with you." And so we put a door outside. So we have the five exits. We have a means of escape. God says He will not allow anything to come your way but what He does not provide you a door to escape. You don't have to stand toe-to-toe with the devil. You can if you're submitted yourself to God. He'll flee from you, but He will provide that means of escape. Got to move on. Time keeps going. In addition to the blessings of the past, in addition to the blessings of the present, the real plus is the future. The Christian stock may not be worth much now, but praise God, we're going to skyrocket someday. We're going to go over the top someday, and the stock market won't know what hit them. You can be confident that the same Christ who forgave your past and keeps your present will guard your future. All tenses of life are taken care of. He has saved you from your past. He keeps you right now in your presence, and you will never be condemned in your future. He that hears my word and believes on him that sent me has everlasting life and has passed from condemnation into life. The Bible says, I give unto them eternal life that they shall never. And that is one of those double deals. Never, 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 never. Never perish. Neither shall any man pluck them out of my Father's hands. You say, well, that's putting a lot of confidence in yourself. No, no, I'm not putting any confidence in myself except for the fact that I'm in the hand of God and you're in the hand of God, and that big old hand is what's holding on to me. I'm not holding on to God's hand. That song that says, hold to the hand, hold to God's unchanging hand, baloney. You don't hold to that change. He holds on to you. My dad had great big hands. They called him Big Hand down at the power company. But he'd wrap that hand around you, you know you was got. I mean, he'd wrap that thing plumb around you, and you knew that you were in the hands of your Father. Whew. You're in the hands of God. I am convinced. The Bible says, I am convinced that nothing, nothing, death, life, angels, principalities, things present, things to come, powers, height, depth, any other thing can separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Let me tell you what that does not mean. That won't mean it. That does not mean you won't have difficulties, because you will. Yeah, you will. You will have difficulties. There will be COVID-19s coming your way. There will be the plagues of 1918, or there'll be the swine flu, or the whatever kind of flu. There'll be something coming your way. We have a lot of people in our church that are sick. A lot of people now just chose not to be able to come out. I think about Ernie with a double lung transplant. It would be foolish for him to come out in this kind of stuff. Foolish. And so I say, Ernie, stay home. I'll preach to you through this microphone right here. And he listens and he watches. Simple truth is, you're going to have difficulties. These things have I spoken unto you, that in the world you will have distress, difficulties, tribulations. But you just be of good cheer. Why? Because I, Jesus said, have overcome the world. Yeah, I'm in charge. I got this. That does not mean that you won't have any desires to sin, because you will. If you say that you have not sinned, you deceive yourself and the truth is not in you. But oh, have I got good news for you. You can claim the promise if we confess our sins. He is. Now, watch this. If we, that's a condition. Okay, if we confess our sins, the rest of this is what he'll do. He is faithful. He is faithful. He is just. He's forgiving. He is cleansing to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. He does all of these things if we do that first thing, if we confess our sins. You can possess, you can enjoy your Christian life. If God says that you have it, then you've got it. He forgets all your past. I'm glad God doesn't say, when I get to heaven, Tom, buddy, I got a long memory. I can remember. I don't want God to say that to me. No, I've got stuff in my past I am ashamed of. I'm not proud of. But I got a hot flash for everybody else. All that stuff is forgiven. It's forgotten and it's forgiven. Because the Bible says, never, 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 never will I ever, 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 ever leave you. And never, 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 never will I ever, ever, ever forsake you. Now, we know that, right? And since we do know that, it's time to start paying forward. Other people don't know what you know. Other people do not have the privilege of knowing what you know. Other people do not know what our children's church knows. Those kids know more than the average person out there in this world about the Bible, about Jesus Christ, and about His love. Praise the Lord, that's right. So pay it forward. Use every opportunity you can. Take this and share it with somebody. Just hand it to somebody. Just hand it to somebody. I sit up at Lois's and I watch people as they look that thing. They look at it. They pull it up out of that thing. Pay it. It's covered up like this on the back part. Pay it. Pay it what? Pay it forward. What is this? They say, you can take that if you want to. This is free. Can I take this? This is free? Sure, it's free. Take it. Take it and hand it to somebody else. It's amazing. Running 30, 35 copies through Lois's every week. People are handing them out. Pay it forward. Pay it forward. Pay it forward. You ready? I'm going to heaven someday when I die. But until that time, I want to take as many as I can with me. And you're part of it. You ready? Let's start paying it forward. Heavenly Father, you are Almighty God. And you're in charge. And you're God. And we're not. So, Father, I pray in Christ's name, you'll speak right now to every person here who does not know you in the free pardon of sin. There are people outside of our church, perhaps, or maybe even inside our building right now, that do not really know for sure that they know for sure that they know for sure that their sins have been forgiven. So I pray right now that they will find that comforting thing of knowing, if I confess my sins before you, the Bible says I can be forgiven. Does that apply to me too? Me too? Me? Yes. Eyes are closed, heads are bowed. I tell you, the worst sinner in the world's already been saved. The Apostle Paul says, I'm the chief of sinners. The worst sinner in the world's already been saved. That means there's room for everybody else. Right now, if you've never done that, do it right now. Look up at him spiritually and say, I want that. I want what that preacher's talking about. I don't understand everything, but I want that right now. I want my sins forgiven. I want to know that I have confidence in Christ. I want to know that. I want to feel that confidence. I want to know that. I want to know if COVID-19 takes me out, I'm ready to go. I want to know if I get killed in the parking lot going out of here. I want to know that I'm ready. I want to know if something happens right now. If Jesus comes today, I want to know that I'm ready to meet Him. Father, I pray in Jesus' name you'll speak to every heart here. Thank you for the opportunity of ministry for today. Thank you for this opportunity that we have right here. Now, Lord, I pray in Jesus' name you'll bless that one or two or more that's praying that prayer right now. And I'm like what Johnny said a while ago. I'm waiting on people to tell me that they're in heaven because of something that they heard at the church or whatever. I look forward to that. I thank you for that. Sow the seed. That's what we're doing. You give the increase. Thank you, Father. Bless us together. We want to give you all the praise for it all. One last call. If you do not know him in the free pardon of sin, right now is the time. Step out. Spiritually, step out to him and say, that's what I want. I want that right now. I want that right now. And I'll do that. Nobody's going to come to you. Nobody's going to embarrass you. Nobody's going to make an example out of you. It's just something, a personal thing between you and him that you're doing right now. You'll want to tell somebody about it later on, but right now is the time. Step out and say, yes, this is it. I want this. I give you all the praise, dear Lord, for what you're doing right now. In decisions that are being made, choices that are being made, callings that are being answered, because you love each one of us enough to send your son to die for us. Thank you for that. Be with us and bless us together. Protect us. Let us do what we can do to protect what we have, to take precautions. But when all is said and done, we are in your hands. And that's where we want to be. Thank you, Father. In the name of Jesus Christ, we humbly pray. Amen and amen.